Dear students, in this video, we will discuss the density of states, that is, number of orbitals per unit energy, and that is denoted as density of states. So, already we have obtained an expression for Kf in 3 dimension as Kf is equal to 3 pi square n divided by V all raised to 1 by 3. So, taking cube on both sides, we get Kf cube is equal to 3 pi square n by V. Then n is equal to this expression which we have already obtained, that is n is equal to V into Kf cube divided by 3 pi square. Also, we have epsilon F, that is Fermi energy is equal to H cross square by 2m Kf square, and Kf is equal to from this 2m by H cross square into F raised to half. Okay. Then total number of orbitals of energy less than or equal to E, this in general n is equal to V by 3 pi square into, for Kf we are substituting the value Kf cube is equal to in terms of energy. So energy is 2, Kf is equal to 2m EF by H cross square all raised to 1 by 2 raised to 3, that is equal to 3 by 2. Therefore, n is equal to V by 3 pi square into 2m by H cross square all raised to 3 by 2 in general. This is the case of Fermi energy and this is general case. Therefore, density of states that is equal to dN by dE, that we can differentiate this. So, V by 3 pi square is a constant. Then 2m by H cross square raised to 3 by 2 is also a constant. Then differential of this is 3 by 2 e raised to half. Therefore, d of E is equal to V divided by, you can cancel 3 by 2 and 3, 1 by 3 cancel. So, it is V by 2 pi square into 2m by H cross raised to 3 by 2 into E raised to half. Then, suppose we take 3n by 2e, that becomes 3 by 2e into V by pi square into n, which we have already obtained here. You can substitute here that value. So that is equal to 3 by 2 e into V by 3 pi square into 2 m e by H cross square raised to 3 by 2. So this expression which is equal to V by 2 pi square into 2 m by H cross raised to 3 by 2 into e raised to half. So e and this e and e raised to 3 by 2. So the remaining is e raised to half. And we can see that d of E, that is density of states, that is equal to 3n divided by 2e. So that is the relation, one of the expression for density of states in terms of the energy and number of electrons, or number of total number of atoms if each atom contributes 1 electrons. Next, we will discuss the heat capacity of electron gas. According to classical statistical mechanics, if a particle is free and then its energy is 3 by 2 kBT, where kB is the Boltzmann's constant, then suppose if there are n atoms and each atom is contributing 1 electron, then the total energy of such a system with the free electrons will be E is equal to 3 by 2 nk bt. So it's a specific heat will be, that is CE is electronic specific heat will be di E by di t, and that is equal to 3 by 2 nkb. So but the observed electronic contribution at room temperature to the specific heat capacity at room temperature is usually less than 0.01 of this value. So this value of specific heat CE is only contributing 0.01 to the total value of the specific heat capacity of the substance at room temperature. So we have to explain the reason for why this is like that. So the total specific heat capacity is specific heat capacity due to phononic heat capacity is there, and this electronic heat capacity is there. So we can take the density, we have the expression for density of states as d of E is equal to V by 2 pi square into 2m by h cross square all raised to 3 by 2 into e raised to half. That is, density of states is proportional to e raised to half. Then we suppose we take the expression for this. Suppose we plot a graph between density of state, not g of here, it is should be d of E versus energy, then the graph will be a parabola, and the nature of the parabola will be like that. So if E is equal to EF, at E is equal to EF, so at E is equal to EF, you can see from this, that is, here you can see, this at E is equal to EF, at E is equal to EF, so almost all the energies are filled, levels are filled in this region, and beyond that region, the energy levels are unoccupied. But when temperature increases, the nature of this graph changes like this, such that it will be in this form, in this curved form. It will be of this curved form given in this figure, that is this curved form. So there is a chance of, that is when T is greater than 0. So that this is the case at T is equal to 0. All the levels less than that of EF is completely occupied. When temperature is greater than the absolute 0, then what happens is that some of the level above this epsilon F are occupied, and probability of occupying this gives in the form of a curve, and the probability of occupancy is of the order of kb into t. So that is the electrons which are of having energy kbt near ef, it has a tendency to occupy the highest energy levels. So that is the case when temperature increases. That is where we can see that when T is greater than 0, only electrons whose energy is in the range kBT near EF are excited. So when T is greater than 0, this some of the electrons are excited to this higher energy states, and those electrons which are of having energy kBT near to EF are only excited. So using these, we have to see fraction of electrons excited will be equal to n into kBT divided by epsilon F, where epsilon F is equal to kB into T. So that will be equal to n into T by TF. So this comes because, so kBT is the energy of occupancy. So out of total EF, only kBT are excited. So this is the expression. So since we have 2n electrons, so the total fraction of electrons excited will be is equal to n into T by TF. So the energy of corresponding energy will be n into T by TF into 3 by 2 kBT. That is equal to 3 by 2 nkb into T square divided by TF. So in the starting, we have taken the total energy as 3 by 2 kBT, nkBT itself. But here, we can see that the energy is 3 by 2 nkB into multiplied by T square by TF. So, this is the reason why the observed electronic contribution at room temperature to the heat capacity is less than that of 0.01 of the mentioned value. So instead of E is equal to 3 by 2 nkBT, we have to take E is equal to 3 by 2 nkB into T square by TF. Since when the high, as temperature increases, almost not all electrons will not be excited to a higher stage. Only those electrons having energy near to having energy in the range kBT near to EF are excited. So from this we can see the electronic heat capacity as C electronic C is equal to dI E by dI T, that is equal to 3 by 2 NK by TF is a constant. Then differential of T square will be equal to 2T. So that is equal to 3 NK into T by TF at room temperature. This value is less the classical value 3 by 2 nkb by a factor of the order of 0.01. Since TF is equal to 5 into 10 raised to 4 Kelvin. That is the ratio T by TF is 3 by 2 nkb T. In the first case it was 3 by 2 nkb and in this case it is 3 nkb into T by TF. So the reduction in the value of electronic contribution to specific heat capacity can be explained by this, that is the fraction of total number of electrons which are excited as temperature increases. So we will get a correct explanation for the electronic heat capacity at your room temperature. Then at very low temperature, we can see at very low temperature KT is far less than EF. EF is equal to this temperature is very low, so this Fermi energy and suppose we compare both of them, so KT will be far less than epsilon F. So at T is equal to 0, we have this energy is given by E0 and that is given by integral 0 to EF. The maximum occupied energy level is EF, so we are integrating between the limits 0 to EF. Then the E into F of E into D of E, DE, that is the expression for finding the energy at a particular time, this temperature range. So this D of E stands for the density of states, that is number of states having per unit energy between E and E plus DE, and therefore D of E into DE is the number of orbitals between E and DE. F of E is equal to 1 at this T is equal to 0. So by multiplying E with the, this is the Fermi Dirac this expression, that is then D of E is the density of states. So the nature of this Fermi distribution and with the this energy is shown in the graph. You can see that is when T is equal to 0, this becomes, where T is equal to 0, this is only this is equal to the one value here, this corresponds to one value. When T is greater than 0, the nature of the graph will be like this, and the Fermi distribution law is given by 1 by E raised to E minus H by E minus mu divided by KBT plus 1, and at T is equal to 0, this mu is equal to EF, mu that is a chemical potential is equal to EF. So when T is equal to 0, we can substitute the value, E minus mu becomes E minus EF divided by plus 1, so that is equal to 1 by 1, that becomes F E raised to 0 divided plus E raised to this term becomes 1 by E raised to 1 by K0 into T. T is equal to 0, so E raised to infinity, 1 by 0, that is infinity. So E raised to infinity is 0, so 1 by 1 is equal to 1. So in all other cases, it is an exponential function. So we can find out the value of this energy at T is equal to 0 as integral 0 to EF, then integral 0 to EF, okay. Then E into D of E, DE, since F of E becomes 1 at T is equal to 0. Then differentiating this expression with respect to T, dou E0 by dou T, since it is a function which is does not contain any T value, therefore this is equal to 0, since the expression for D of E is independent of T. Now at a different temperature T, we can express the value as ET, and it will be equal to integral 0 to infinity E into F of E D of E into DE. When we increase the temperature from 0 to T, the energy difference will be E is equal to ET minus E0. ET minus E0. So the electronic heat capacity will be dou E by dou T. And that will be equal to dou ET divided by dou ET, because dou E0, it is dou E0 divided by dou T, the second term, this is independent of t, so c electronic becomes dou e t divided by dou t. So we can substitute the values here, so that is equal to integral 0 to infinity. Then dou by dou t of e t is equal to e into de into e into de into de into f is there. So d of e is a function which is independent of e, so all these are taken outside, and we have to take the differential with respect to this f with respect to t only, because f is that is distribution law only depends upon temperature. Now put this as equation number 1. Then we have the expression for n becomes integral 0 to infinity f of e into d of e, that is the expression for finding the total number of atoms under the condition that each atom contributes 1 electron. Then substituting this value, we'll get integral 0 to EF. So only atoms are occupied in the Fermi level. We can take 0 to infinity, instead of 0 to infinity we can take 0 to EF into, on that region we have F of E is equal to 1. So this becomes d of E into DE, since dou n by dou t is equal to 0, that is total number of electrons is a constant. So now we are multiplying EF with into N. So EF into N becomes integral 0 to infinity. EF is multiplied, then F of E into D of E, E, D, E. So here not a G, it is D of E into E. Now we are taking this differential of this expression, that becomes EF into dou N by dou T is equal to integral 0 to infinity, then EF into d of E into dE into dF by dt. So that is the differential, only the dependent factor is dF by dt. Put this as equation number 2. Then equation 1 minus 2 gives, equation 1 minus 2 means it is, we will get, so the equation 2, again it we can write it as 0 here, because dou n by dou t is equal to 0, dou n by dou t is equal to 0. So the second expression becomes this integral value, integral value that is equal to 0. Now you can assume this 0 here on the left hand side and this term on the right hand side. So on this subtraction 1 minus 1 from 2 from 1, we get C electronic. So in the first case we have C electronic on the left hand side. So C electronic C is equal to integral 0 to infinity. Then that you can take the two integrals, both of them have the limit 0 to infinity. E term, one is E into d of E de into dou by dou t, and the other one is EF into d of E de df by dt. So combining that two terms, you can write it as integral 0 to infinity E minus EF into d of E de into dou by dou t. So this d of E is a constant which is independent of t. Then integral 0 to infinity E minus EF into de into dou f by dou t. Since we have taken instead of d of E here, we have taken d of EF at outside here, because df by dt is considerable only at E is equal to EF. Only at E is equal to EF, this df by dot is considerable. Therefore, d of E becomes not g of E, that is d of E becomes d of EF. So we have taken this d of EF outside this. Now we can evaluate this value of this integral, that is we have f is equal to 1 by exponential e minus ef by kbt plus 1 at e is equal to ef, mu is equal to kbt, and this chemical potential e minus mu becomes e minus ef by kbt plus 1. So that is df by dt will be equal to 1 by exponential becomes minus 1 by exponential square. into then the differential of this one, that is exponential differential exponential itself, into then e minus ef divided by kb, again into then differential of 1 by t is minus 1 by t square. So the total value becomes, you can see by multiplying all these, we will get e minus ef by kb t square into e minus ef by kb t divided by e raised to e minus ef by kb t plus 1 the whole square. Now we can substitute these values here. So that is a here we have C electronic is equal to d of ef into integral 0 to infinity e minus ef the whole square by kb t the square, because one e minus ef already here, then exponential e minus ef by kb t, then divided by exponential e minus ef by kb t plus 1 the whole square into dE. Now in order to evaluate this integral, put x is equal to e minus ef by kt, then ef e minus ef is equal to kbt into x, therefore dE is equal to kbt into dx. So this is our equation number 3. We can take the equation number 3 here. This is the equation number 3. So we can take the equation number 3, and C electronic becomes d of e into integral. The limit value also changes when this dE is equal to 0, this x becomes minus infinity, and when e is equal to infinity, again x is equal to infinity. So the limit of integral becomes minus infinity to infinity into, you can substitute the values, e minus ef becomes kbt into x square, kbt square into x square, then e raised to x into e raised to x into divided by kbt square, then this becomes e raised to x plus 1 the whole square, then dE becomes kbt into dx. So here it is kbt into dx. So this integral becomes, C electronics is equal to d of e into from this kbt square here, in the denominator kbt the whole square, in the numerator remaining is kb square into t, taken outside from here, then the integral is minus infinity to infinity x square e raised to x dx divided by e raised to x plus 1 whole square, and the value of this integral is 1 by 3, because the value of this integral is not 1 by 3, it is pi square by 3, you have to write pi square by 3. So pi square by 3, okay, then we can substitute here the values are, therefore C electronic is equal to d of ef into kb square into only t here, t square is not there, t here, into pi square by 3. So the we have d of e is equal to v by 2 pi square 2m by h cross square raised to 3 by 2 e raised to half, and n also we have written here. Then we have obtained an expression in terms of d of ef is equal to 3n by 2 ef, that we have already shown in the density of states. So by substituting that expression, d of e f is equal to 3 by 2 n into 3 by 2 n by ef, then the expression for electronic heat capacity C E L becomes 3 n by 2 ef, that is for d of e, into kb square into only t, kb square into t divided into pi square by 3. Substituting, we will get 3 and 3 get cancels, so it is equal to pi square by 2 into n into kb square into t divided by ef, that is equal to 1 by 2 pi square into n into kb square into t divided by ef is equal to kb into tf, then that is equal to, the expression is equal to C electronic, that is equal to pi square by 2 n kb T by TF. That is, for one mole, we can take NK is equal to 1 R. So, this electronic heat capacity, that is proportional to T. That is, all these are constant. Pi square by 2, NKB, TF, all these are constant. So, the electronic heat capacity is proportional to temperature at a low temperature. Long temperature case la. So here expression aanu nammal kaiya chapter la nammal use cheyittunde electronic heat capacity de expression eduthittana nammal endu cheyidathu adinde thermal conductivity evaluate cheyittullathu aa samayathu yan paranjittundirunna next chapter la nammal discuss cheyyunnu parannittundirunnu. So this is expression, how this expression comes we have seen here. So we have obtained the expression for electronic heat capacity at room temperature and also at low temperature. In both cases, although the values are different, both are proportional to temperature. Now we can see the what is the experimental heat capacity of metals. Temperature much below both the Debye temperature and the Fermi temperature, the heat capacity of metals may be written as the sum of the electron and phonon contributions. So there will be contributions from electrons and phonons to the heat capacity of metals. That is, C will be equal to this gamma T plus A T cube. So that is thermal this phononic heat capacity we have obtained from the Debye T cube law, as C is proportional to A T cube. Then this is the electronic contribution, that is C is equal to C electronic plus C phononic. So suppose we draw a graph between C by T, then it will be equal to C by T will be equal to gamma plus A T square. So from this we can draw a graph between C by T along x axis. C by T along x axis we can take, C by T along x axis we have taken, and T square along y this x square x axis, and C by T along y axis we have taken. Then this corresponds to the graph of a straight line with this is gamma is the y intercept, and slope of this will be equal to A. So graph will be a straight line. So the slope of C by T, T square graph will be equal to A, the constant of proportionality in the case of Debye law, and y intercept will give us the proportionality constant in the case of electronic heat capacity. So because of the interaction of the electrons with the periodic potential etc., there will be there will be some change in the mass of the electron, and the effective mass of an electron, thermal effective mass, and the original mass is related by the expression m thermal divided by m is equal to gamma observed divided by gamma free. Free electron case only. In the gamma observed case is the actual case. So this is the mass of the electron itself, and this is the thermal effective mass, and that will be is equal to gamma observed divided by gamma free. So if there is an interaction, there is an interaction of the conduction electrons with the potential, periodic potential of the rigid crystal lattice, and the effective mass of an electron in this potential is called the band effective mass. So this we can see here. See, electronic is given by pi square by 2 NKB T by TF, which is equal to gamma T. Gamma is given by 1 by 2 pi square NKB divided by TF. Epsilon F is equal to KB into TF. Therefore, we can say that gamma is proportional to 1 by TF. That is also proportional to 1 by epsilon F, but epsilon F is equal to directly proportional to H cross square by 2M into KF. That is, gamma is inversely proportional to 1 by F, means gamma is directly proportional to M. The next reason for the change in the mass is the interaction of the conduction electrons with the phonons. That is, an electron tends to polarize or tends to distort the lattice in its neighborhood, so that a moving electron tries to drag nearby ions along, thereby increasing the effective mass of the electron. That is another reason, its interaction with the phonons. The first one was it's a interaction with the periodic potential of the rigid crystal lattice, and the third reason for this change in mass is the interaction of the conduction electrons with themselves. A moving electron causes an inertial reaction in the surrounding electron gas, thereby increasing the effective mass of the electrons. these are the three reasons by which this how this thermal effective mass of the electron occurs. Now connecting with this, we have a concept of heavy fermions. Means in F electrons in certain compounds like this UBe 13 cesium, then CeAl3, then CeCu2, Si2, etc. That is, they have inertial masses as high as 1000 m. Because in all these F electron states is there, and because of the weak overlap of wave functions of F electrons on neighboring ions, these electrons have a thermal effective mass which is high as 1000 m, and such electrons are termed as heavy fermions. That is all about this specific capacity, electronic heat specific capacity, and the total specific capacity of metals.